different kind of life. You're silent, bold, the wind is cold, you must return to the wild.
So we find ourselves waiting to see if the family returns safely from their wild camping adventure. The last we saw of them was yesterday as they were disappearing over the edge by the car park.
I think what worries me is they weren't really dressed for going off. What worries me is it's 8 o'clock and they weren't really dressed for, yeah, like they had jeans on.
Jane.
Yes.
You call this wild camping. We often get accused of this not being wild camping. That's wild camping. Isn't that just wild camping?
It's freezing cold.
It's cold.
Said the man that slept with 2 blankets and a heater.
It's not freezing cold. I mean, you can go to Greenland and it's freezing cold.
Can we wait until they get back? Otherwise, I won't sleep tonight.
And to say I'm concerned for their well-being is an understatement. It's been so cold in the night that we've slept in our thermals, under a quilt and a really thick throw-over. I was expecting the car to be gone by the time I woke up, and I can't just drive away without knowing they're okay. And eventually I managed to badger Stu to go up and take a look to see if he can see them as the morning's getting really late.
Stu's just gone to have a look. I'm sure they're absolutely fine. And they're raising 2 superhumans. But look, Mister, it's not cold out there. It's oh God, bloody idiot.
Sorry, I thought you said it wasn't cold out there.
They're over there.
Can you see them? And the kids are running around.
Yes.
Wow.
You're panicking there.
They're just superhumans. And to save on gas, Stu seems to have turned into Paddington Bear, with bread and marmalade becoming his breakfast favourite. And we're off, and that, as ever, is one of our favourite park-ups.
I was just talking to that man. Yeah. His kids are 2 and 5.
Oh, right, so I thought he was about 7.
Yeah, I did.
Night,
and then they went out last night, and he said it was really stormy, about 1 o'clock in the morning.
But yeah, it went cold. I didn't hear the wind pick up though, so it must have done. Well, but they're on the ridge there. They were camped on the ridge.
And he said that they absolutely love it when they get in the tent, they're bouncing around. It's a great thing, isn't it?
Yeah. And we head towards Lake Bala, or is it Bala? The valley below is a really great view, and what a place to have a farm.
A good park up. We always like that. We always tap us nice. We got up well today and we had a better. The last 24 hours have been a lot better all round. I think we got ourselves a bit into the swing of it a bit more. We're now heading towards Jane's mum's up in Southport today, but we're first of all going to go to, I think, Chirk Castle.
Oh, okay.
So it's about an hour away. Jane ran all the way down here
and walked back.
Yeah, she hasn't run for some time, I'd say, have you?
Yeah.
That was good. Walked back, it was a bit more hillier going back on.
And we both ache yesterday from our walk, don't we?
Hey, yours. Good one. Come on, mate.
Go back on.
Hey. Well, he should have bloody just gone back. So come on. Why didn't he just pull in where he was?
So did Stu give in too fast? Should he have waited to make the car go back? I know what my thoughts are.
She was right by a place. Well, that makes total sense. We'll reverse back.
And we finally reached Chirk Castle. And those gates that we presumed were the entrance were actually near the exit. We're starting to judge National Trust places by the length of the drive, and this one is impressive. What a great location, and I must say, we do a great castle in the UK. So even if you just want to go for a walk, then this location has some great ones around the grounds, with the castle at the centre of the walks.
Oh, I think I'm taking to the special space. Oh, next to that, I kid. Oh, even you can't have a parking moment with that, can you? Well done, you parked first time because someone told you where to go.
Shut your face. Of course I did. I'm a seasoned profession. Oh God, here she goes again. We only just walk through the entrance. Knows the answer. Knows the answer.
The cafe looks really busy today, although it's a public holiday, which has obviously brought everyone out. We make our way up the castle on the hill. Chirk Castle was part of Edward I's iron ring of fortresses that circled North Wales, and it was built between 1219 and 1310. In the years that followed, it was remodelled and changed hands many times, and it was handed to the National Trust in 1981. The castle has great views all around.
The primroses are out.
We enter the inner part of the castle. The Welsh flags fly well in the wind. We make our way through the various rooms. This was an interesting item, especially as it was made out of wood. The pipe is a water pipe from the London New River Company from the 17th century, which supplied London with its first clean drinking water, and the project was led by Thomas's brother. These mirrors are made with a mercury coating which we now know to be toxic, and it was in 1835 that they started replacing them with silver. We then explore the various old towers and dungeons and cellars. Then time to get back out in the fresh air and discover the formal and informal gardens which make this a really good destination to go to.
Well, I wish I was here when that went down. It would have been a right crack. Down there is Chirk. I think that's the Cadbury's factory.
So that was a great day, and as always, it was helped by some good weather. And we would definitely recommend a visit. And as usual, I take some pictures for our trip album. But everything must come to an end and it's time for us to get on our way.
Turn left now.
We now head towards my mum's house in Southport, travelling past Birkenhead and through one of the tunnels that go under the River Mersey. Ever do visit Liverpool, then please take the Mersey tunnel tours that they do because they're absolutely brilliant. And as we drive through Liverpool, we see a random fair has popped up due to it being a bank holiday. Well, that's it for this video, so please join us in the next one where we show you some of the sights of my hometown of Southport. Southport.